Mike Renner here, breaking down Louisiana Tech edge defender Jaylon Ferguson. Very good chance of being a first-round pick come April. He reminds me a lot of last year's small school defensive end Marcus Davenport. Ended up going in the middle of the first round to the New Orleans Saints. A lot of similarities in their game, and when you watch them, the thing that pops off the tape consistently is Jaylon Ferguson's ability to bull rush. He has explosiveness, he has size, he has length, all that combined just murdered those small school offensive tackles that he faced. This is the UTEP game from earlier this year. One drive, as we'll see here, three plays where he just absolutely dominates this left tackle. If you run it here, the first bull rush just takes him all the way back into the quarterback's lap. That was a constant theme through him throughout the year. He's the NCAA leader in sacks this past season because he continually pushed the pocket like that. This is the very next play in that two-minute drill to end the game here. Pretty much all of Ferguson's move counter off that bull rush. The fact that he's so explosive up the field that he has to make offensive tackles worry about playing right through their chest, that he uses that bull rush to his advantage, and as you'll see here, counters with an inside move off of it. All the way into the quarterback's lap for the sack. Like I said, that is his go-to move. We'll see a few more plays here about how deadly that bull rush was. Again, later on that same drive, Ferguson once again against the left tackle. They realized that it was a mismatch. They realized he was getting his butt whipped. They try to help out with the running back, but Ferguson once again, the explosiveness, just too much. And this is what you think will translate to the next level. When you have an offensive tackle who just doesn't have the core strength to hold up to a bull rusher like that, he's going to be able to consistently collapse the pocket like he does on this play. Just absurd how powerful he is already for a small school player. Now, he's far from a perfect prospect, as we'll see in a little bit, but that's the kind of stuff that gets you excited about his potential moving forward. The thing you wanted to see is that sort of bull rushing prowess, that strength and explosiveness translate not just to small school guys, because a lot of guys can beat up, you know, group of five tackles, but he came against LSU and had one of the best games we saw against a talented LSU offensive line. Here he is lined up over the right tackle, and you'll see once again if you'll run it, he long arms this right tackle with his right. He was adept with bull rushing with two hands, one hand. It was a consistent theme throughout his tape on the season, as you'll see here. No chance there. Tackles on skates consistently. That's the stuff that you like to see, but here we're gonna see in a second the thing that gives you even more excited about his potential moving forward. On these videos, you'll hear me a bunch talking about how you need multiple moves to win in the NFL. If you are just a bull rusher, the NFL offensive tackles are far stronger and far more technically sound than the tackles you'll see at the college level. You cannot simply have one move and expect to be a consistent pass rusher. Ferguson, obviously the bull rush was his go-to. It was overpowering. It worked against college offensive tackles, but he flashes enough bend and usage of his hands. While he's not there yet, he could get there at some point, and that's why, like Marcus Davenport a season ago, who, again, was primarily a bull rusher, but flashed just some with his hands. So if you can develop him at the next level, you think he might be a special player when it's all said and done, because you bet on these sort of athletic traits. If you'll run it here, you see him go rip to the outside move, bend around the edge, force the throw away. Like I said, it didn't happen too often, but there are flashes of it where you can talk yourself into, say, hey, I have better coaching than he probably got at LA Tech. I'm gonna be able to get him to do this time after time after time. And that's why he'll probably be a first rounder come April.